Hi, my name is Sai Krishna. I'm a grad student in the Computer Science Department at UCLA. I did my undergrad in Computer Science from IIT Madras, India. I graduated in 2014. So I've been here for 2 years, and I guess I will graduate another 3 years maybe.
So you graduated in 2019, hopefully.
Yeah.
So you're doing PhD in Computer Science.
Yes.
And did you have any work experience after undergrad?
No, I directly joined here.
PhD?
Yeah.
So you're doing Masters along the way?
Yeah, I'm doing Integrated Masters and a PhD.
So do you think it's better to do a Masters and then do PhD?
I don't really think it matters. I think just doing an integrated course would be as good as doing a Master and separately applying. In fact, I think if you can, doing an integrated course would be better because you would get
full funding, right?
Yeah.
Because otherwise most masters, they pay for themselves,
exactly.
Right? That's a smart move, actually.
Yeah.
So, and it's also good because if you already decided to be a PhD,
exactly.
So that's good.
You can get done with it faster than doing it as two separate programs.
I see. So did you have any research publications in your undergrad?
Yeah, I had a couple of papers in my undergrad, one during my undergrad thesis and one as part of the summer internship.
So that helped you get into a PhD program?
Exactly.
I see. So what kind of research do you do?
So I work mainly in cryptography, theoretical cryptography, designing encryption schemes and more secure, in general, schemes for security.
I see. So, where all did you apply?
So, I applied to about 10 schools and I got admits to 8 of them. I picked UCLA because I think it has the best program for cryptography.
So, can you tell us where you had admits, for example?
I had admits from University of Illinois, Urbana-Champaign, Cornell, UCSD, NYU, Georgia Tech, Rutgers, Maryland.
So why did you pick UCLA over the others?
In my opinion, I think UCLA has the best group for cryptography.
Mm-hmm.
And my interest was in cryptography, which is why I picked
UCLA. Okay, you started in 2014.
Yes.
So how many students were in your batch, PhD, computer science?
I think there are about 25 to 30.
Oh, okay. So everyone had complete funding?
I think so. I'm not sure. I believe almost all of them would have had complete funding, but I'm not sure of the particular details.
Okay. So, what about your GRE and TOEFL?
So, I got 160 in my...
Total out of 340?
Out of 340, I got 329.
Oh, that's a pretty good score.
Excellent.
And then
I got
117
in TOEFL.
I see. So, did you study on your own?
Yeah.
Did you use any online resources?
I think I used some word lists online.
Okay.
Some vocabulary list, but I don't remember from where. I just Googled them and picked the first 2-3 links that came.
So, on 5-star, how much would you rate your experience here?
I would give it 5.
5? Oh, very good.
I really enjoyed my stay here.
Enjoyed everywhere? Okay. What about the cost of living? Do you live with roommates?
Yeah, I do live with roommates. The cost of living is probably a little high, but the area is pretty safe and I've had fun.
I see. So, what kind of advice do you have for future students? Is there anything, which you wish you had done better?
No, I can't really think of anything that I could have done better in some ways.
Okay, so looks like you're a happy-go-lucky person. So
yeah,
I see.
Having fun.
So,
I would just say that UCLA is a good place in terms of the academics and as well as the...
So how did you shortlist universities? On your own or you consulted your friends or you went to career agency?
I consulted my faculty in my undergrad institute.
I see.
And based on their advice, I shortlisted the universities.
I see. So you plan to get into academia or industry?
I haven't yet decided, but I want to work in a research environment. So it might be in academia or in industry as well.
So did you do internships anywhere?
So I interned at Microsoft Research India in my first summer of 2015. And last summer I spent at UCLA itself.
Okay. So thank you very much and best of luck.
Thanks.